Good evening, Sunflower graduates, honorees, friends who are participating from home via live stream. I'd like to welcome you all tonight to the Sunflower Bakery and our annual appreciation and graduation celebration. I'm Orly Panich, and I am a member of the Sunflower Board. Together with Lisa Benjamin and Sherry Heller, we are the co-chairs for this evening. We are thrilled to celebrate our 21 graduates and distinguished honorees tonight. So first and foremost, we have been through a horrible and tragic and trying year, and with deep gratitude, we are very grateful to our community, in particular this year, as well as the last 11 years. So it is really with your involvement that we are excited for what the future holds. Each and every purchase and donation affirms your confidence in and support for Sunflower. And Sherry?
Okay. Good evening, everyone. I am Sherry Heller, and I thank you all for joining us. Our host committee did a terrific job spreading the word about tonight and inviting friends and family to celebrate with us. Over the past 11 years, Sunflower has developed many meaningful relationships throughout our community, which provide the foundation for our success and confidence to meet an ever-growing need for employment training and teen job exposure. Sunflower is a true example of the whole being greater than the sum of its parts. Our many relationships with our young adults and teens, their families, educators, disability professionals, employers, as well as our community leaders, Montgomery County government, board of directors, foundations, donors, and customers complete our whole circle. Lisa?
And I'm Lisa Benjamin. We would like to acknowledge those who helped make this year's event possible. Our gold level corporate sponsor, Sandy Spring Bank, our many wonderful event sponsors, including Amazon, Bernstein Management, Chevy Chase Breast Center, Goldfarb and Associates, Neiman Collaborative, Republic Services, SPC Financial, S. Friedman and Sons, the Agency DC, and Wegmans, plus numerous foundations and many, many individual donors. Join us now for a flash tour of our new home. We are elated to finally thank those who have dedicated the many rooms and areas in which we learn, train, produce, greet, and congregate.
And thank you, Sam and Leslie, for the beautiful and welcoming entryway.
Thank you to Danette and Theodore Lerner Family Foundation, Cohen Lerner and Tannenbaum Families for the Sunflower Reception and Bake Shop area.
Open Wednesday through Friday, our Sunflower Bake Shop is filled with delicious desserts and makes everyone a little hungry when they come in.
Thank you to the Mayberg Foundation for dedicating the Sunflower Bakery front office.
This office is the place to get information of our training programs and delicious products.
Our executive director's office is dedicated to the memory of Dinah F. Rosoff by the Engel and Butter families.
This is where the executive director helps to ensure that Sunflower continues to grow and strive to best serve our students, our customers, and the public.
Our employee development hub, enthusiastically dedicated by Dottie Bennett, provides a classroom space for pastry arts and hospitality program students to train and practice basic skills.
Also serves as Sunflower conference room and boardroom.
Oh, Def. pantry is dedicated by the Harry and Jeanette Weinberg Foundation.
The staff pantry is a great space for students and chefs to eat lunch and take well-deserved breaks.
This is where we started training with the chef. We learned about basic baking methods, ingredients, how to follow recipes, and so much more. Our training kitchen is dedicated by Ben Pollinger.
After 12 weeks of basic pastry arts instruction in the training kitchen, we spend 12 weeks in the production kitchen receiving more hands-on training. Together, we baked 52,000 hamantaschen in this kitchen this year, 2,000 pies and tarts, and 5,300 challahs, and so many cookies, bars, and cakes.
Our production kitchen is dedicated by the Bernard family, Kathy, Alex, and Amanda.
Our combination program office and classroom is dedicated to the memory of Cecil and David Rosenthal by Naomi and David Balto.
Cecil and David continue to inspire us to be the best we can be as productive members of our community.
Good evening. I am Scott Ryder, and I serve as chair of Sunflower Bakery. Thank you to our community of donors, the Montgomery County Executive and Council, and the state of Maryland for making our new home a reality. And this evening, a thank you to Orly, Sherry, and Lisa, and your host committee for helping to organize this wonderful celebration. Sunflower Bakery has always been inspired by the teaching of the renowned rabbi and philosopher Moses Maimonides, that the highest form of tzedakah, the pursuit of righteousness, is helping people to become self-sufficient. Our mission, to provide transferable and marketable employment skills to people with learning differences, has this pursuit of righteousness and justice as its core. In 2020, in Maryland, only 34% of adults ages 18 to 64 with a cognitive disability who sought employment were employed. In Washington, D.C., this number was only 21%. Sunflower's employment training program directly addresses this urgent need with professional skilled instruction, employee development training, and employment services. This year, we also expanded our service area to work with the Rehabilitation Services Administration of Washington, D.C. Since our inception in 2010, we have served more than 465 young adults and teens through our employment training and teen exposure programs. And this year, we strengthened and established relationships with employers including Woodmont Country Club, Wise Markets, District Donut, Wegmans, Dawson's Cafe, Adventist Shady Grove Medical Center, Vie de France, Pop-Up Patisserie, Praline Bakery, Soulful Cafe, and Carmen's Italian Ice. We look forward to continuing these relationships and finding additional employment opportunities for graduates of our programs. And now I would like to call on Lori Wexler, our executive director and co-founder, who will recognize our incredible staff and public officials.
Good evening. Thank you for being here. Your attendance means so much to us. Tonight, you have no idea. We're so happy to see all of you. We are delighted to recognize not only our graduates and honorees, but also our talented and dedicated professionals who are most definitely the backbone of Sunflower. Our team is committed to providing essential skill training, mentoring, and guidance. They are equally passionate about our compelling mission and providing our community with fabulous desserts. I would like to give a special shout out to our tremendously dedicated staff. And please stand afterwards. Lauren Granberry, Esther Herbers, Liz Hutter, Sandy Joswick, John Katz, Sherilyn Lewis, Sarah Portman Milner, Anna Myers, Janice Neville, Joey Nowicki, Marion Pitcher, Daphna Raskis, and Cindy Tepper for their hard work and devotion. We really cannot thank you enough for all your efforts and your long hours and your passion and dedication. Before we go further, I would also like to thank our terrific public officials who are our cheerleaders and partners in fulfilling the mission of Sunflower Bakery. Participating via live stream are Montgomery County Executive Mark Elrich, Council President Hucker, Council Members Albernaz, Friedson, Glass, Jawando, Katz, Navarro, Rice, and Reamer, State Senator Cheryl Kagan, and State Delegates Gilchrist and Palakovich. And now we invite you to learn a little more about our programs. We started Sunflower Bakery because there are just not enough places where young adults with learning differences can have choices to make decisions about what they want to do with their lives.
We train young adults into different bakery and hospitality and food service industries. When people come to us, they don't know what it's like to have real expectations asked of them. People have been doubting them all their lives. I think a lot of people write them off way before they've ever given them a fair shot. And I think that's really the biggest struggle.
I was a kind of a nervous wreck. I barely ever left the house. I certainly didn't have a job.
Usually when the students come in the beginning, the work ethic is very low. So that's one thing we really instill in them.
Our chefs are professional chefs, so there are expectations in our kitchen that are hard.
My first day, I felt a lot of anxiety. It was something very new to me. I never experienced anything in the kitchen before.
My first day at Sunflower, I was excited, but nervous. They pushed me to follow the recipe one step at a time and pay attention.
We have to teach them how to be employees, which a lot of them have never been.
It took a lot of practice, a lot of determination, and I just had to say to myself, okay, I want to succeed, and I'm gonna do this, and it just had to come from within me.
And that's really what we here at Sunflower really pride ourselves on, being able to give students an ability to learn that they can succeed.
I learned how to do things while staying calm. And when I learned things, I could just do them and I didn't need to worry about it.
After some time here, I started to get a hang of things and I realized I was telling myself, I can actually do this.
Now I'm in job training. I've got friends.
Bake shop contact, bake shop display cooler.
We believe in their ability to be successful, to have a job, to maintain a job, to go forward, to succeed, and to grow.
Seeing that student from the beginning all the way to the end, that self-confidence they develop is amazing.
Thank you very much.
And we've had many small businesses throughout Montgomery County that have taken not one, not two, up to five students of ours because they're such wonderful, dependable, loyal employees.
I just got offered a job position at Adventist Healthcare in Shady Grove. I can take what I learned from Sunflower and apply it to what I have now.
I'm very grateful to be in this program for all the training and support that I've gotten.
I think just knowing that it's not going to be like stressful and difficult forever is a tremendous help.
Sunflower was the right choice for me.
Hi, I'm Dottie Bennett, a longtime longtime Sunflower board member, advocate, and customer. I have the great pleasure today to help Sunflower recognize a Montgomery County treasure. Now, in all fairness, Kathy is not here with us today, but she's so ably represented by Alex, her son. So I'd like to ask Alex to come up and join me here at the podium. My friend Kathy Bernard is a doer, and she does for so, so many. Kathy was introduced to Sunflower a few years ago at this very type of event. That was all it took. Since then, in addition to being an incredible supporter, Kathy took the reins with determination to find Sunflower a new home and has helped us develop good relationships with our landlord, which we all know is very important. Kathy takes to heart the communal responsibility of helping young adults of all abilities and interests find their paths to adulthood, especially through the arts and education. For many years, Kathy was a prime engine behind much of the pioneering work done at Ivy Mount School. Bethesda resident and arts philanthropist, in 2014, Kathy established the Bernard Ebb Songwriting Competition in memory of her uncle, Fred, the late great Fred Ebb. Our awardee has served on the boards of Roundhouse, Strathmore, Imagination Stage, the Bethesda Arts and Entertainment, and particularly close to me, she serves on the Signature Executive Committee, of which I am incredibly proud to be Signature Theater's board chair. Kathy's business acumen as president of real estate management and investment firm HCM, and impactful civic engagement in Montgomery County continues to be recognized by so many. Today, it's Sunflower Bakery's turn to honor Kathy for her unstinting devotion to making this community a better and a more compassionate place. Alex, on behalf of your amazing mother, wonderful friend of mine, I am honored to present you.
It's beautiful. It's so beautiful. Thank you.
With this beautiful mosaic and the plaque, which reads, "With abundant gratitude to Kathy Bernard for commitment to making dreams happen. Sunflower Bakery, 61321.
Hello. This is such a fabulous event. Dottie, those words were very, very kind. Thank you so much. Obviously, I'm not my mom, but I am representing her today. And she's cheering Sunflower on tonight. We want to congratulate the staff and students here for making such a beautiful space. My mom always says the first time that she came here, she goes, it was such an ugly warehouse before. And this is so beautiful. You have made it a real home. My mom loved and still loves working with Lori and Daphna, though she could not always do what they asked. It's with our great pleasure to support what you do here at Sunflower. You help students and young adults learn skills and enable them to have careers that might not be available to kids with learning differences. You prepare them to be self-sufficient and you teach them productive skills. You do very important work here. On behalf of our family, we wish you many more productive years. We hope you make good use of this beautiful warehouse, and which we know will have lots of love all throughout. Hopefully you'll grow and get even bigger and better, which is what we want. My mom feels good that she has helped and relocated what should be a model for all. Creating self-sufficiency and giving your students and the community something to be proud of. Good luck in your new home, and we look forward to continuing to buy your amazingly delicious baked goods. Mazel tov.
Ron, if you'll please join me up here. Ron Halber dedicates himself to the communal and political well-being of the entire Greater Washington Jewish community. He's led the Jewish Community Relations Council with finesse since 2001 and is still going strong. He develops strategic initiatives, secures tens of millions of dollars for partner agencies of the Jewish Federation of Greater Washington, including Sunflower, successfully advocates for the passage of statewide and local legislation, develops creative new pro-Israel initiatives, and strengthens relationships with other faith and minority communities. You may wonder how Ron gets it all done. We know the answer firsthand. Prior to COVID, Ron was Cafe Sunflower's best coffee customer. Often stopping in for coffee twice daily, Ron always had a kind word for our students and staff. Our students would greet him with a smile and take pride in guessing his coffee order and the treats he would bring home to Michelle and their three kids. Ron always made a point of bringing Sunflower cookies to meetings with local and state leaders, and he often brought important guests to Cafe Sunflower. When it came time for our expansion, Ron's knowledge of and relationships with local and state government leaders were essential to realizing the dream of our new employment training center. Sunflower Bakery and the Jewish community of Greater Washington are most fortunate to benefit from Ron's passionate and strategic approach toward community relations. Ron, it is my pleasure to present you with this Sunflower Mosaic. The plaque reads as follows: with deep appreciation, Ron Halber, for tireless efforts building community impact. Sunflower Bakery, 61321.
Thank you, Scott, for those kind words. As the executive director of the Jewish Community Relations Council of Greater Washington, I deal with dozens of Jewish organizations, synagogues, social service agencies, schools, you name it, but Sunflower has always had a special place in my heart and stomach. And it's not because I insisted on being their first customer to have my dollar hung on the back wall, or because I am their economic stimulus package buying approximately 6 cups of coffee, which is one habit I've weaned myself out of during COVID, one bowl of soup, and another snack daily. I'm in love with the vision and the mission of the organization. Sunflower provides skill job training and employment opportunities in the baking and hospitality industries for adults 18 plus with learning differences. Can you think of a more succinct, heartwarming slogan than caring is our main ingredient? When you walk into the Sunflower Bakery at the Federation Building, you're immediately overcome with a special feeling, and that is not just the delicious smell of the high-calorie snacks. Every purchase is a mitzvah. The food you purchase was baked by an individual learning a skill, and the same for the person who worked the cashier. People learning skills that build self-confidence and put them on the road to independence. Now think about that for a second. Building self-confidence and providing independence. As you alluded to earlier, Rambam says the highest form of tzedakah is to help someone establish themselves to make it unnecessary to be dependent on others. Sunflower fulfills his most important Jewish value and mitzvah every day. Sunflower's lay leadership is outstanding. Its staff is first rate. It has partners in the corporate, nonprofit, government, and private sectors. It is a true community unto itself. The organization does not sit still and is not content with what they have achieved. They are always striving for more, and that is the hallmark of an organization destined for continued greatness. And their new building facilities will help make that possible. So, to Sunflower's fabulous president, Scott Ryder, and executive director, Laurie Wexler, the staff, trainees, board, donors, and everyone else that helps to make Sunflower Bakery the great organization that it is, continued best wishes for an even greater future. Thank you.
Liz, will you join us?
Oh.
this is kind of where it began, right? The three of us.
Over coffee.
Right. I remember the coffee print. We are so delighted this year to honor Chef Liz Hutter, who actually needs no introduction in this room. Coming to Sunflower in January 2011, Liz has been with us almost since the beginning. We were impressed with her interest and experience in teaching others, her extensive knowledge about pastry arts, and her willingness to take on our mission. Chef Liz jumped right in. With the help of another chef instructor, she created and implemented our pastry arts curriculum, the foundation of our program. In addition to a myriad of other responsibilities, Liz is in the kitchen instructing every day. Her role has evolved over the years, committed to Sunflower in whatever is asked of her: executive pastry chef, employment specialist, general manager, and now culinary director. As Liz has always said, she is in it for the long haul. In addition to the tremendous value that Liz has brought to Sunflower as the visionary and implementer of the pastry arts program, she has developed our recipes and robust menu, which have no doubt helped many of you to celebrate holidays, communal events, and family life cycle festivities. Her organizational skills are a true gift and bring the structure that is required in our busy kitchen with many, many moving parts.
Hi, I'm Sarah Portman Milner, Director of Student Services and co-founder. Creating the direction of our menu, being responsive to Jewish holidays, some of which she had never heard before, and being mindful of baking trends while simultaneously incorporating student abilities, maximizing their strengths and meeting training goals, Liz is the penultimate conductor of our pastry arts orchestra. When visitors walk through our kitchens, they see many people working intensely, doing various tasks, from making buttercream frosting, to rolling pie shells, to pounding hamantaschen dough. And there are no voices to be heard, just the hum of ovens or roar of the mixers. That's no accident. It's because Chef Liz had made sure that everyone has learned their part, that they have practiced to work independently, that they're skilled with the instruments of their trade, and they have risen to the occasion.
We couldn't be more fortunate and are forever grateful that Liz chose Sunflower. Our program and community have been the beneficiaries of her tremendous talents, creativity, and true grit, in spite of the calories she readily doles out. Chef Liz, thank you for all of the time, teaching, and heart you have devoted to developing skilled employees at Sunflower. With awe and heartfelt gratitude to Elizabeth Hutter for dedication to developing skilled employees.
Thank you. I'm not going to get emotional. Thank you, everyone. It has been a pleasure to serve this community for these past 10 years. I am so proud of all the graduates, past and present. We have come a long way this year and from where we started on Ziggy Lane. It has been the work of so many to get us here, and I am honored to be a small part of it. Nearly half my life, I have been baking professionally. When I started on this path, I was completely in love with the food. I couldn't believe I got paid to make lemon curd, ice cream, and chocolate ganache. But as the years went by, I became less fulfilled and started to think about moving on to a new career. Don't get me wrong, I still love to bake, but I knew there was something missing. I stumbled upon Sunflower Bakery right around this time. I realized within months of working here what was missing in my professional life. It was the relationships. Some may call it purpose, but it's the people I've been privileged to work with over the years that has made this job so meaningful to me. Seeing the changes in the students over the months and now years is a part of my life I would never have wanted to miss. I have learned more than I have taught. This has been a remarkable experience for which I am truly grateful. Congratulations to all the graduates, and thank you again for the opportunity to serve.
I am Joe Inowicki, Hospitality Manager. 4 years ago, as a Cafe Sunflower customer, Sue recognized that trainees employed at the counter also needed to improve their social and communication abilities. Since then, she has volunteered almost once every week at Sunflower, providing for professional speech and language pathologist skills to students in our cafe and hospitality training programs. In both of those programs, verbal and nonverbal communication are key. Sue has engaged every member of the group in conversations and role play that not only reinforce topics relevant to the task involved in providing excellent customer service, whether at the cafe or here at the bake shop, but also in their daily lives. She has played an integral role in our student success.
We all felt comfortable and enjoyed practicing conversations when we met with Sue. She was always so nice and helped us learn to do better. Sue has been nurturing, encouraging, empowering, patient, and above all, caring and fostering our confidence to succeed. Sue, thank you for all of what you have done for us. I really appreciate it.
Thank you so much for the recognition you gave me today. It's a joy to come to work here and to work with my friends in the hospitality program. Our participants need to feel comfortable and confident to speak to their employers about what they need on the job, their accommodations, such as a chair to sit in if they're behind the counter, a walker, or written directions or oral directions. And they need to tell their employers this when they're out on the job. They also need to be really comfortable with their coworkers and customers when speaking with them, because that's how you keep a job in our society. Social language is often equally or more important than work skills. Thank you.
Thank you to all our amazing honorees for the helping Sunflower to achieve all that we do. I'm John Katz, and I serve as Sunflower's program director. Having joined Sunflower in May of 2020, I've been continuously blown away by our students and the opportunities that their newfound skills are presenting for them. Despite the added challenges faced because of COVID-19, our graduates and employee partners describe it best.
Sunflower graduates are on the move as they get trained and hired throughout Metro DC in competitive employment, utilizing their newfound skills in pastry arts and hospitality. They are employed in a wide range of food industry businesses, including supermarkets, local markets, hospitals, caterers, country clubs, specialty bakeries, cafes, and a chocolatier.
I'm working at Woodmont Country Club. I am the jack of all trades. I do bakery department, I work as a line chef, I fry, I cook.
So we employed Ethan from Sunflower, and it's been an amazing opportunity to get to work with him and work with the program. I think that working with somebody with a learning difference in the kitchen isn't so much a challenge, it's just learning where they fit in the best. So a lot of times there are certain aspects that they're very interested in, it's just kind of channeling that. I would recommend to anyone interested in working with anyone with a learning disability to really entertain the idea, because it's very rewarding, and it's awesome to see how much that person gets out of it.
For our students with learning differences, skilled vocational training addressing individual learning needs has been shown to be the most dependable path as they transition from school to adulthood.
My name is Murray Wright. I recently graduated from Sunflower Bakery, and now I work at District Donuts. I do all the prep work for in the mornings. At Sunflower, I learned how to be a team player. It really made it better for me to work here. Communication is a big thing when it comes towards like working as a pastry chef.
Murray is awesome. She shows up to work on time every day. She's super excited. It's hard for people to be happy when they come to work these days, so it's really nice to see her with a smile on her face. Staffing in this industry, in the restaurant industry, is super tough. You know, being with Sunflower has been awesome to just have these trained employees come in. They know how to work a scale, a mixer, things like that. It's been really helpful to run a professional environment.
I'm Andrew Tucker, and I'm 20 years old. What I love the most about Sunflower is the desserts that I make and the brownies and the blondies and helping pack orders. Sunflower is a good place and I learned a lot here.
Learning hands-on by doing in a professional bakery setting, each student's needs are addressed as they develop the hard kitchen skills and receive the preparation to be successful employees desired by employers. These hard and soft skills help them not only to gain employment, but to adapt to opportunities that will lie ahead.
Well, my name is Demba and I'm 27 years old. I really like this, doing the different kinds of recipes. I know how to make the hamantash dough and sunflower. Really good at like memorizing some recipes.
Sunflower graduates are becoming income-earning, productive members of their communities, experiencing a sense of accomplishment that leads to increased confidence and self-esteem.
My name is Luis Neiman, and I am 23 years old, and I work at a place called Pop-Up Patisserie. I mostly run the front, but I also help out with any other type of prep as needed. What I learned at Sunflower that prepared me for here is probably the respect for the people who are above me. If you're interested in baking, go to Sunflower. They're really supportive. They teach you a lot of good things, and it's just overall a good place.
We actually decided to go ahead and hire somebody from Sunflower. I think it's been helpful for everybody. Somebody on staff who was a graduate of Sunflower 2 years ago is now joining us full-time next week. I think you have to really look at it as a win-win situation. I think you're helping out somebody, and at the same time, they're doing the work that you actually need to be done. What I think we learned more than anything else is that a Sunflower student is essentially the same as anybody else. So that means that they fit right in.
My name is Connor Pennington. I am 25 years old. I work at Pretty Bakery. That's Fairfax, Virginia. I ice cupcakes. I sprinkle the cupcakes. I like to make chocolate chip cookies. I like to make yo macaroons. When I was at Sunflower Bakery, I took the SurSafe test. Score 100%.
Connor came in as a bakery assistant and works in back in our kitchen. He does a variety of tasks, but he came to us knowing most of them. He was trained to ice cupcakes, to know how to use a pastry bag, how to use knives. So So Sunflower was really able to teach him the things to get him started. I would definitely recommend a student from Sunflower, a graduate from Sunflower, to work in any kitchen.
The dignity and respect our graduates develop from their training positively impacts their relationships with supervisors, co-workers, family, and friends. They thrive on the success of being valued, productive, contributing members of their team and their communities.
Students who train in our pastry arts and hospitality programs have a few things in common: learning differences that have challenged them throughout their educational experience, making it harder to find and sustain appropriate training and employment, perseverance to learn and achieve transferable and marketable skills, and a positive attitude to meet the expectations of the workplace. I have met with amazing business owners and supervisors throughout Metro DC who are eager and pleased to hire Sunflower graduates. They tell us that hiring a Sunflower graduate and others with learning differences has proven to be good for business because they are trained, qualified, and can do the job. They are reliable, understand the demands of the workplace, and are ready to do what's asked. And they add diversity and inclusiveness to a workplace.
This evening, we're honored to graduate 16 students from our pastry arts program and 5 students from our hospitality program, our biggest graduation class yet. You can now see for yourselves, after seeing the video, how their perseverance and positive attitudes pay off. Expectations do matter. Before we introduce our graduates, I'd like to call Liz Hutter and Marion Pitcher, Senior Chef Instructor, to join us up here, please. Marion? Rain, snow, and sunshine, Liz and Marion are at Sunflower, along with our dedicated team of chef instructors, to instruct, train, and supervise our students. Our pastry arts program is 26 weeks long and includes instruction in pastry arts skills and techniques, soft skill instruction, practice, serve safe food safety and production responsibilities under close supervision. Pastry arts graduates, please come forward together to receive your certificates of achievement, along with a citation from the Montgomery County Council from Chef Liz and Chef Marion. Come on up. Come on over here. You can line up over here. Graduates, once you have received your certificates and plaques, please walk over here so that you can stay together for a picture, okay, for a couple minutes. Please hold your applause till the end. I promise I'll make sure you know when that is, okay? First, Osemin Agbedian. Hold applause till the end, please.
Austin Agrafiotis.
Jolie Band.
Demba Sese.
Ethan Edwards.
Katrina Hainer.
Michael Kelly.
Luis Neiman.
Connor Penninen.
Ellis Rogers Archer.
Cam Shorter.
Ashley Thompson.
Hannah Tagaye.
Andrew Tucker.
Last and certainly not least, Maureen Wright, and now you can clap.
Hold on. And Jacob Van Houter, another graduate who is watching via live stream. Congratulations to our Sunflower Bakery and Pastry Art graduates. Tonight, we are also thrilled to celebrate our hospitality graduates. These students participated in our newly revised 26-week hospitality employment training program, which includes classroom instruction in customer service, interpersonal communication, packaging, serve safe, food sanitation, barista skills, money skills, and soft employee preparedness.
Day in and day out, Joey Nowicki prepares our students for work in the hospitality industry. His dedication, enormous patience, and desire for his students to succeed is laudable. Hospitality graduates, please step forward to receive your certificates and County Council citations from Joey when your name is called. And please hold applause.
Alvaro Cervantes.
Gary Copeland. Junior.
And last but certainly not least, Michael Pessin. Unfortunately, Kylie Huntington and Jess Willie could not be with us today, but we'd like to congratulate our hospitality graduates. And now, thank you, and you may be seated. And now, a special message to our graduates from County Executive Mark Etler.
I want to thank you for inviting me to participate in this graduation event and giving me the opportunity to congratulate this outstanding class of Sunflower Bakery graduates. I applaud Sunflower Bakery's dedication to providing job training and employment opportunities to adults with learning differences. The work you do is very special and is changing lives. To the graduates, Sunflower has prepared you for your next step. From the pastry arts training program to your hospitality employment training classes, you've made it through and are now ready to practice your craft. You've received the top-notch training that will enable you to compete with others in the hospitality industry. You have the tools and the confidence you will need to be successful, and I'm confident that all of you will have an impact on the organization that you'll work for. I know you are excited to finally reach this day. I also know it's been difficult, but you all saw it through. You've accomplished a lot, and now you can each focus on showing the world what you can do. I only ask that you never forget what Sunflower provided you: opportunity, confidence, and skills to succeed. I urge you to give back to this program and help the students behind you to get to where you are today. Believe me, the fulfillment you will get from helping someone will be priceless. So congratulations to Sunflower Bakery, the students, teachers, and of course the graduates. Best of luck to each of you. I know you will do well and make us all proud. Thank you.
Congratulations to all the graduates, and thank you very much, County Executive Elrich, and everyone here and everyone at home for joining us here tonight. Each of you really plays an important role in setting our graduates on paths to productive and fulfilling adulthood. I'd like to make sure you all know that you're invited into the bakery after this event for a tour, and the bake shop will be open so you can bring home delicious treats. Oh, and there are bags on your table to bring goodies home. Before we conclude, a quick shout out to Mike and Denise Setta for the student-led flash tour and Double E Entertainment for their technology know-how. We look forward to all being together in person next year. Best wishes for a safe, happy, and healthy summer filled with sunflower treats.
And now for our raffle. I will call out the three winning individuals who are either in person, at home, or someplace wonderful. If you are not with us in person, please email us at info@sunflowerbakery.org to make arrangements to receive your cake or gift it to someone in the Metro DC area. Thank you again for your participation this evening. Our raffle winners are Judy Frank, Gwen Crane, and Jamie Thompson. Congratulations. Thank you so much for coming. There are goodie bags on your way out, so please grab one. And again, thank you.